thank you. Yeah, welcome back here. I'm going to get right into this because I want to learn a lot about it for Kevin's sake.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Brandywine Senior Transitions, and this is Diane Durbin.
Yes.
Yeah, and you're the president and co-founder and all that?
Yes, but now I'm the only founder that's still in the company.
Oh, so you are the founder then?
Yes, my partner retired in 2007, and she works part-time with us, but she's no longer an owner.
Yeah, now when you talk about you guys, I guess there's got to be a big need for this out there.
There's a tremendous need. The issue is that most folks don't even know this type of industry now exists.
Right. Now, you guys do all kinds of different things. I guess let's say I'm getting to that age. Is that when I contact you? You wait until, you know, how do people get involved with what you're doing?
Well, when there's the need, normally they get involved, but usually it's on the late end. And what we recommend to people is planning and knowing the resources that are out there so that if that need arises, they know where to go to.
Yeah.
And so the earlier, the better. It doesn't mean you actually employ folks and spend money at that point, but the sooner you know about it, the sooner you can plan your future.
Yeah, now what kind of planning do you, I guess as a senior, you know, because I'm working with my mom right now, and you know, she's getting that, my dad passed away. I mean, so I guess you got to look at all that you know, and some planning, because right now she's having to do a lot of different things, just try to adjust the finances and all that.
It, you know, a lot of it comes down to what she wants to do. If she, you know, has found after her husband passed away that staying home is in a house is a bit too much work, maintaining it. There are plenty of wonderful retirement communities out there, or apartments or whatnot, even kids' homes.
Right.
And we basically plan and execute all the logistics associated with change. So let's say she wanted to leave her home. We would help her figure out, you know, what appropriate retirement community might be out there. That's just a very small piece of what we do, though, and we only do it as required. I mean, clearly people come to us oftentimes and they know where they want to go. The core of the business is in helping them figure out what to take through formal floor planning so they don't try to shove a four-bedroom house into a two-bedroom apartment, and getting the move and the pack and the move set up. And then once we have everything on the other end, we unpack for them, so we set up their new home. So they're not, you know, stressed and trying to figure out how to unpack all of this stuff into a smaller environment. And then we deal with whatever it is they've left at home, either by sale, gifting, charity, the good old trash can, whatever it is they want to do. We even ship things if that's what they need. And then once the house is empty, we get homes ready for sale. So oftentimes they've lived in the house for 30 or 40 years. They haven't necessarily kept it up. And, you know, this is a tough market, but, you know, in any market, a house that shows well sells well. And we've had a lot of good success, even in this market, cleaning, repairing, and dressing or staging homes for sale.
So that's kind of, I guess, where you're more into the move of the seniors versus, you know, are there some other planning that you do as well? Or?
We're into the move, but we're into the disposal of excess goods. We're heavily, especially now, into getting homes ready for sale because people are so afraid of actually making the move because, you know, they're worried their house isn't going to sell, and the stock market's down, and, you know, the economy isn't.
And plus trying to get them out of that, you know, and making that a wise decision. I find a lot of your elderly folks like where they're at. They've been there so long, and, you know, and that's got to be a big stress in itself.
It is a big stress, but, you know, at some point, home is not always the best option. We do support some folks that are in their home. We take care of assisting with temporary transitions. So if somebody's in the hospital or really lucky in spending the winter in Albuquerque, we take care of vacant property, not tenants. That's a realtor's job, and we're not realtors. But we will take care of vacant property. We'll pay their bills. We'll, you know, get rid of snow, we'll do home checks, whatever it is.
Make it seem like somebody's actually still living there.
Exactly, we do all of that. And we also deal with estate property. So when someone passes away, you know, oftentimes if, let's say it's a husband and there's a surviving spouse, They're focused on the emotions, you know, the funeral arrangements and all of that. And we focus on the logistics of, you know, the house, the stuff in it, all of that.
Right.
And lots of times, again, you know, that surviving spouse may, after a period of time, just decide that they're really lonely and they want to move.
Because you're saying that you plan for the transition. So even at my age, I could call you and you'd like educate me on what kind of insurance policies to get as I got older that I'd need to...
No, we're not insurance providers. Think of a pie. There's a pie in place, and every slice is a different professional. And through your life, you should be looking at the various pieces of the pie. One piece might be the financial planner, which some in effect, some financial planners get, and they look at insurance, so that's kind of their piece. You know, you should do funeral planning. You should do planning. A part of insurance is long-term care insurance, and part of planning for that is, well, do you plan in the future on staying in your home, and do you want to do everything possible to stay in the home, which might include modifications of the home, looking into companion care.
Right, I mean, would you help me plan the planning? Or am I too young?
You're never too young to plan, but our slice of the pie is if what's in your cards is, you know something, I might want to move to Florida, or I might want to move to an apartment. We don't really care where you're moving. We help with the front end in that case.
I got you.
If you're moving to a place in our operating area, then we will help you with the back end, the settling in piece. But when it comes to looking at insurance policies, financials, we recommend that you go to a financial planner, an insurance agent that you've done your due diligence with, and you know that.
So it's mainly for relocation, and getting rid of your house and getting it ready to sell and everything, so you get the maximum dollars for the house.
That's
important, especially if you're moving into a nursing home or retirement place. You know, it'd be nice to be able to pay cash for that or take care of that means.
Yeah, right. Be able to stay there long enough.
Yeah, because I find that's a lot of reasons that people don't want to move. Their house is paid for. They haven't got any bills for that. And the last thing they want to do is incur more bills.
Right.
So if you can sell that house and get the whole profits from that to purchase the next one, and then you have those ones that move out of state and just want to retire and go to Florida and don't want to deal with it. So a great company. How did you guys come up with that concept? I mean,
we designed it on a blank piece of paper.
Yeah.
Over lunch.
Yeah. Yeah. I guess. Were you in real estate beforehand? Or?
No. And in fact, one of the pieces of the puzzle that we also do is some seniors haven't bought or sold a house in 30, 40 years and are really nervous about what realtor, how does the process work, you know, and they want somebody to be a consultant through that process. It's a neutral party. We get involved in vetting realtors, interacting with them.
Be sure they ain't getting ripped off. That's a big
deal. That's a big part of what we end up doing.
Yeah, and for more information, they go to your website. It's
www.brandywineseniortransitions.com.
Yeah, now I understand the transitions. Yeah, transition from home to home.
So, from home to home.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that anytime soon, but I'll think of you when the time
comes. All occurs in a day or two.
Oh, yeah, you just never know. It goes fast, that's for sure. I want to thank you so much, Diane, coming in and filling us in. If you got more questions or anything, just contact the website there on the bottom of the screen and let them help you get a plan for your retirement, I guess, is what
the goal
is.
I think I'll give Judy's folks a call.
Yeah.
Get them out, get me in the beach house, let her help all with that stuff. That'd be good.
That'd be wonderful. There you go.
See, I'm planning my pie.
Can you get rid of my wife at the same time? That's what he's saying. All right, well, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we got Mrs. Delaware. Yeah, so, and we'll find out what she's been up to and what kind of trouble she's going to cause for the pageant.
I'm going to go through her phone.
So, you stay with us. Be right back right after that.
To find out more about the Tim Kroll Show and other Positive Promotion productions, then log on to our website at www.posprotv.com.